저 기우야. 그 시기 왜 그 윤기사 윤씨 맞지? 원래 이 집 운전기사던 놈.
네, 윤기사.
뭐 그 친구는 뭐 지금 다른 데서 일하고 있겠지? 일자리 구해가지고.
아, 그럼요. 그렇겠죠 뭐. 워낙 젊은 나이고 허우대도 멀쩡하고.
그렇지. 어. 더 좋은 사장한테 갔을 거야.
에이 씨발 진짜!
야 이게 왜 이래 또?
우리는 우리가 제일 문제잖아. 우리 걱정만 하면 되잖아. 어?
There are a lot of excellent videos that talk about what's so great about Parasite. There's a lot to love. So instead of talking about the symbolism of smell,
곱등도 없어요.
그래 그래. 요새 곱등이 너무 많아.
Or this stone.
가정에 많은 재물운과 합격운을 몰고
가시면서. 야 이거 진짜 상징적인 거네.
Or the imagery of height representing upper and lower classes and how water relates to that.
뭐하냐 거기서? 어?
And the comparison to movies like Kurosawa's High and Low, or even talking about something that I haven't seen anyone mention, how the rich families seem to view Native Americans quite highly, but still partake in offensive and damaging stereotypes, which aligns quite well with the way corporations praise their employees and then go on to pay them poverty wages.
그때 우리가 짜장하고 나타나가지고 제시카 쌤을 습격하는 겁니다. 이 인디언 도끼 막 휘두르면서.
Instead of all that, I wanted to talk about how Bong Joon-ho so effectively takes two wildly different halves of a movie and makes them fit together. How did Bong Joon-ho create the mortar between two films?
기정아, 물 하나 줄까?
어, 텔레파시, thank you.
Psycho famously did a similar thing when Hitchcock unexpectedly killed off the main character halfway through. Event Horizon changes from a sci-fi space epic into a horror halfway through. Full Metal Jacket drastically shifts tone after Sarge's speech and the sniper.
Wherever you are, every Marine is your brother. Most of you will go to Vietnam. Some of you will not come back.
From Dusk Till Dawn, in my humble opinion, was the best example of this prior to Parasite. The first half being a crime thriller, which with the help of a snake and a Selma Hayek dance number, turns into a campy vampire action horror with an appearance from Tom Savini himself. So what makes Parasite's transition between halves so special? The story follows Ki-woo and the family as they slowly infiltrate Gun Se's home, taking every available position. This first half plays out almost like a heist, or I guess more like a long con, sort of wrapped in a darkly comedic satire. By the midpoint of the film, the family did what they wanted to do. There was nowhere left to go. They had all the jobs, they were making good money, they'd pulled off the con. So this is where Bong Joon-ho gives us a few minutes to decompress. The film comes to a standstill, and the family gets a moment to live the lavish life that they wish they could have had. There's nothing in this moment on screen to suggest what would happen next. But Bong Joon-ho very effectively makes this scene tense, if only through our meta understanding of film. We know that this movie's 2 hours long, and we're only an hour in. Our main character succeeded. Something has to happen. But we're given nothing. Okay, maybe not nothing. We're given a moment that tricks us into thinking a new conflict has arisen, but it turns out to be a joke in the moment. But it does act as some foreshadowing of Ki-taek's growing anger.
아버지, 안 돼요. 죽어요.
맞지. We're given 5.5 minutes from the time where the other family leaves to go camping before the doorbell rings. 5.5 minutes of uncertainty. 5.5 minutes of the audience getting inside their heads trying to figure out what's to come. And when it comes, we're presented with a truly eerie performance which sets the tone for the last half of the film. At this point, the film becomes a thriller and, at times, a psychological horror. But none of this would have worked without allowing the audience time to try and figure out what was going to happen, so that the film could subvert their expectations. Bong Joon-ho brilliantly gives us space to create the tension ourselves, which allows the last half of the movie to be even more jarring, frightening, and uncomfortable.
누구세요?
안녕하세요. 저는 저기 사모님 안 계시죠?
예?
아 저는 여기서 아주 오래 일했던 사람이에요. 저 지금 보고 계시는 그 모니터 위에 강아지 세 마리 사진 붙어있죠, 그죠?
So I was going to make a bunch of videos that cover all the Academy Award categories and what I would have nominated, but a bunch of stuff came up and it was a lot of work to even get going. And now the Oscars are in the past, so I'm probably not going to make videos for all the categories, but I will do Best Non-Binary Performer and Best Child Performer, since the Academy doesn't have those awards and I think they should. I do have a video of my favorite films of the year if you want to check that out though. I will, however, make a post on my Facebook page and my website with all my personal nominees for all the categories. Thanks for watching.